Hello friends, today we are learning two component system. The first question arises is that why we should learn two component system. If I take brass for example, brass contains 40% zinc and 60% copper. But how do we get to know that the ratio of zinc and copper is 40:60? If I take 50 gram of zinc and 50 gram of copper, will it give homogeneous mixture of brass? No. It will contain only 33 gram of zinc and the rest is copper. The remaining zinc will remain as an impurity. So how do we get to know that at what temperature the brass alloy is formed and what is the exact composition of brass or any other alloy? So the answer is phase rule, or rather say phase diagram. Let us study two component system for silver lead system. When the alloy of silver and lead is formed, it contains total four phases. These are solid silver, solid lead, solution of silver and lead, and the vapor phase. But whenever the alloy is formed, the vapor is present to the negligible extent, and hence we can neglect the vapor phase, and the new phase rule, that is F is equal to C minus P plus 1, is applied. Remember, the phase rule is F is equal to C minus P plus 2. Out of two, one is temperature and one is pressure. Here the vapor phase is present to the negligible extent, hence we are neglecting the pressure. Hence the new phase rule, that is F is equal to C minus P plus 1, which is called as reduced phase rule, is applied to the system. Let us understand the phase diagram for the silver lead system. On the x axis there is eutectic composition. On the y axis there is eutectic temperature. On the left hand side we have 100% of silver and 0% of lead. On the right hand side we have 100% of lead and 0% of silver. That means when we go from left to right, the percentage of silver is decreasing and percentage of lead is increasing. Then it contains two curves, curve AO and curve BO. The curve AO starts at point A, which is the melting point of pure silver, and the curve AO is called as freezing point curve of silver. It shows the effect of addition of lead on the freezing point of silver. From the curve, it can be seen that the melting point of silver decreases till the point O is reached, where the solution gets saturated with respect to lead and the melting point of silver does not fall any further. Along the curve AO, liquid mixture of silver and lead and the mixture of solid silver and liquid are in equilibrium. In the similar way, along the curve BO, liquid mixture of silver and lead and mixture of solid lead and liquid are in equilibrium. The curve BO starts at point B, which is the melting point of lead, and it shows the addition of silver on the melting point of lead. The melting point of lead gradually decreases till the point O is reached. So point O is the lowest freezing point of lead. So at point O, the solution gets saturated with respect to lead and the melting point of lead does not fall any further. So if we take any example of curve, along any curve, there are two phases are in equilibrium. So when we apply the reduced phase rule, that is F is equal to C minus P plus 1, it is two component system. So C is equal to 2 and P is equal to 2 for two phases. So F is equal to 1. So both the curves are univariant systems. Now we come to point O. The two curves AO and BO meet at the same point O, where three phases, that is solid silver, solid lead and their solution, that is the liquid mixture of silver and lead, are in equilibrium. Hence, according to the reduced phase rule or condensed phase rule, F is calculated as zero. That means it is zero variant, and such system is possible at only one specific temperature, that is 576 Kelvin, and it is possible only for specific composition, which is 2.6% of silver and 97.4% of lead. So this temperature is called as eutectic temperature, and this composition is called as eutectic composition. Here we get to know that the silver and lead will mix with one another to give a homogeneous solution only for the specific composition, that is 2.6% of silver and 97.4% of lead. And this alloy is formed only at specific temperature, that is 576 Kelvin. There is no any other temperature or no any other composition where the lead silver alloy will be formed. We can understand this by taking another example of point P, which contains a mixture containing less than 2.6% of silver. When this mass is allowed to cool, it will cool down without any change in composition till the point P dash is reached on the curve BO. On lowering the temperature, lead begins to separate out and the composition varies along P dash O till the point O is reached. Because the eutectic composition of silver lead system is 2.6% of silver and 97.4% of lead. On further cooling, the whole mass solidifies to the eutectic composition. This means that no mixture of lead and silver has the melting point lower than the eutectic temperature. Also, we can see that there are four areas in this phase diagram. The area marked as solid silver plus liquid, that indicates a crystalline silver and liquid mixture of silver and lead is present. The area marked by solid lead plus liquid indicates that the crystalline lead and the liquid mixture of silver and lead are stable in this area. The area marked as eutectic plus solid silver indicates that a crystalline silver and eutectic mixture of silver and lead are stable in this area. That is, the solid mixture of silver and lead plus there is additional silver is present in this area. The area marked as eutectic plus solid lead indicates that there is a eutectic mixture of silver and lead and additional lead is present in this area, or rather say they are stable in this area. So that is how from the phase diagram of silver lead system we get to know that silver and lead will react with one another only at specific temperature, that is 576 Kelvin, and will react with one another only in specific composition, that is 2.6% of silver and 97.4% of lead. So whenever we have to make the alloy of silver and lead, we have to take 2.6% of silver and 97.4% of lead, and we have to heat that system at 576 Kelvin to give the homogeneous mixture of silver and lead.
Thanks for watching. If you like, click subscribe for more such videos.